man, it's AE chilling out in Ottoman Studios with Dirty Promesa and S.O.T.A. TV. TakeOver Promotions.
We gonna make it. But she's top gonna take it. Whether you're plotting or hating, I give us more motivation. We gonna make it. The seed top's gonna take it, whether you're plotting or hating. That gives us more motivation. We gonna make it. The seed top's gonna take it, whether you're plotting or hating. That gives us more motivation. We gonna make it. The seed top's gonna take it, whether you're plotting or hating. That gives us more motivation.
Welcome to the S.O.T.A.tvseries. I'm DirtyPromesa, and we at Ottoman Studios in the South Bronx at 381 Canal Place. Right now, we got AE that's sitting down in the seat. I know this young man. For about three, four years or so. It seems like time just flies, man. I've been following along.
About 3 years. About
checking
three
him years. Out, man, and following him through Facebook, his Twitter, his Instagram, everything, his social chats, his YouTube. He puts things out, you know what I'm saying? And I'm here to vouch for him, Dirty Promesa. Yo, he's right now, we're going to promote his new EP that's coming out, The Broken Artist. He ripped it in the booth with one of his joints off of that. It's called The Flow. And then he also ripped it again, the second one. It's called Ups and Downs. We're going to check that out later. But right now, we got A.E. He got his entourage in the back, making noise on the chair and everything. You know what I'm saying? But we all good, you know? This is what it is. Stuff that TV series and shit like that. So we're going to keep it moving. So, A.E., how you doing? I always like to introduce myself with a great pal. It's legendary as love. Pinkies up. Loyalty, royalty, respect. Yo, man, like I said, you on the S.O.T.A.tvseries is an acronym for supporting other talented artists, and that's what I'm trying to do for you right now. So how you doing and everything? I like to break it down a little bit before he start to talk, which I should have did. Yo, this is Terrence D. We're going to leave it like that. I got to show him. She gave him a big shout out. A.K.A. A.E., man. Member of the Ninja Nation Coalition, held by Sets, man. You know what I'm saying? A.E. born and raised Brooklyn since 91, up in the Marcy Projects. I'm always around that area. I actually work around that area a lot. You know what I'm saying? Brooklyn's beautiful. That whole Williams Bridge area is dope, man. Yeah. The eateries. I always say Williams Bridge. It's okay if I make a mistake. You know what I'm saying? But I'm out there, yo. You see it. I'm in Coney Island every week trying to get this equipment, put this together. I'm happy you came to support this on the TV. You know, I'm going to give you a chance to talk, but I got to let you know how happy I am to have you sitting here. You know what I'm saying? On the S.O.T.A. TV series, supporting it, man. And I strive to do the best every day, man, grinding for the dream. You know what I'm saying? And I know you do your little thing. Tell people about your little camera thing, because you bought your camera and got your peoples filming this too you know?
Yeah, because I do my own cover art and my music videos as well. So, yeah, I'll just be behind the camera as well at the same time.
Well, don't be too shy, man. Talk up on those mics. You know what I'm saying? We want to make sure we hear A.E. right now, because what you did in the booth was so much confidence that you really, I like that. When you have clarity and confidence behind your work, you're always going to sound perfect and great, man. You know what I'm saying? And I followed you since day one. Since I had a merger with A.J. Simpkins, you know, with the snuff thing. And that's when Sets brought you out, and you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I saw you with your boy. What's the one with the goatee? What's his name again?
Easy slip my Desert. Mind.
Easy Desert. Easy Desert. Man. Well, I Dean Ola, man. And, you're really, once again, like, you gave me the same feeling as you did at Gasolina, man. I'm feeling the energy, and I'm happy you here. I always got stressed that, man. I'm supporting other talented artists. And wherever I can help you out in any other genre or field or what you doing, connecting and networking with you, yeah, I'm down for that, man, for real. But, you know, let's tell the people more, man. Like, I met AE 3 years ago. I already said all that. Coalish came out. You know what I'm saying? I threw up the work with the nation, but you know, I'm just trying to do it professionally. But we can always script this, we always scrap this. But AE's right here now to, you know, to promote his EP, The Broken Artist. You know what I'm saying? So tell me a little more about that. You know what I'm saying? How you want to do it?
Last year, I did a tour with the Ninja Nation.
Mm-hmm. You're always everywhere.
Yeah. It was pretty dope. Atlanta, Delaware, Connecticut. Couple other places too, but so we toured a lot.
How was it touring, man? You know what I'm saying?
It's different. It's very different.
You got the money structure behind you and everything, like to make it comfortable. You like the hotel suites, doing it up, running around with butt naked girls and shit in the hallways and stuff. Well, how was it out there when y'all go touring?
It wasn't that crazy.
Cause I know you're grinding, no matter what. I respect it.
You know, we all focus at the end of the day at everything that we do. So it wasn't that crazy. But it was still different, and it was a really great experience. I'd love to do it again. Trying to set that up pretty soon.
Yeah. And that's how you want to do it for your EP. You want to do it right? Like something like that, like a touring thing, or again, with the nation, or you going to do a solo, because that's what that's what you said. You're doing this as a solo artist.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, for the last couple months, I've been building up my own personal team.
Okay.
Just so I can set up my own tour for everything.
And what's your production crew name right now going on? Like, you got a name for it, or you're just my peoples, let's do this?
No, we ain't really come up with a name yet. Like, I'm still recruiting and everything, so... When I get all that together, it's definitely let you know what's going on with that.
Okay, yo. My man AE sent me a bio, you know what I'm saying? Let's start the clock. I forgot to start the clock on this, but we can keep it rolling. We all know. And you know what I'm saying? I know how to edit shit. But, you know, let's go back to your childhood, because I told everybody who knows about the S.O.T.A. TV, who follows it, it's not just about music. But it is about music. It's all about presenting you as the best I can, you know. Tell the people your struggles and the grind that you have to go. Man, we're going to take it back to... We ain't going to take it back too far. But since you're from the Marcy Housing Projects over there, you know what I'm saying, and famous, known, a lot of, you know, names coming out of there. Yo, how was it as a childhood growing up in Marcy, man? Give people a little detail, man. Well, that's not from Brooklyn.
My perspective may be just a little bit different.
Baby, preach it.
It was cool, alright, for what it was, you know. It wasn't as bad as, I guess, when, you know, Jay and them was growing up, but at the same time, it was still bad. Still got bullet shots and bullet holes and things, and people shooting things at certain times of night for no reason. People still doing dumb shit, but like I said, my perspective would be different because I found myself never within it. You know, like,
How you did that? I'm sure it was difficult as a young lad.
It's difficult, especially because, you know,
that's my word, lad. I don't know why I got it, but that's my word, lad. I mean, it's no disrespect. It's okay.
No, nah, I got you.
I'm not an old man. That's just my word. That's my slang.
It was right for what it was. It's just that you know, I guess a lot of people that I grew up with. Around there, you know, I had to distance myself from, and it was nothing personal. It's just I always felt like I had to be more than the four square walls that was, you know, I was surrounded by, and everything that was going on. So, like, pretty much whenever I got of age to, you know, do whatever I wanted to do, that's what I've been doing. That's what I've been outside of the hood mostly. Do what I got to do for myself to progress.
Hear it
in life.
Your music. See, I go here. Hear it in your music. You ain't come up in this booth talking no nonsense shit.
Nah.
I heard that. I listened to every word. It was wonderful to hear yourself. But you started off as a spoken word artist. That's what helps out now.
Yeah.
Right?
I had.
Tell them more. Tell the people more. I know you, but my people don't know you. So if I ask you, tell you a little more. That's because I want my people to know. AE, man.
I got
straight
you.
Straight up, you know.
Gotta let the people know.
Hell yeah.
That started around. I say junior high school, probably. 113 I went to.
Shout out 113. You got a prodigy, baby.
Let's see. I wasn't even like really, yeah, like you said, I was more with the spoken word. It was something, I was in my class when it was introduced me to poetry and stuff. And like off the jump, like what it was and how you could work with it within writing your words. Mm-hmm. And getting your point across, it just interests me. And from then, I've just been writing and writing and writing. Like, I did, like, maybe two poetry slams.
So that's good, then. That's the next question I was going to ask you. Do you remember your first poetry, man? You said two. Oh,
it was
wow.
Like, it was like
that's
more,
your first poetry.
It was
you said two.
More of a, like, it wasn't, like, a public poetry. It was, like, at a event or something. It was, like, in the school, you know? So... That was a minute ago. But that was when I just started. So, you know, people wasn't feeling that as much.
Yeah.
But
I started at my first open mic, my first performance was at a spoken word. And there's some badass spoken words. And I'm sure if you gave my people's one, you know what I'm saying, or give me one, I'm sure it's some badass shit too, you know? I'm saying it's something like, damn, you throw a beat on that shit, it's like, wow, motherfuckers platinum off the back, yo. But I'm saying you don't remember. You got anyone recently, anything? Cause I like that. My thing is, you know why I ask? Because I say sometimes my poetry or raps, and my raps sound like poetry.
Mm.
You know, so that's why I say that. But you know, you don't have to spit. You know, But that's what it is, you know. So, but I'm so you do you load, so then we're working with Armand Sterling with him doing poetry that amuses you too as you work together.
Yeah, I'm actually I actually recently produced a beat that I'm working with that he's gonna be featured on.
And you did all your beats too, right?
Yeah, especially for this project and everything going forward. I actually started making my own beats the top of this year, and just been working and working. So yeah, every beat on the EP is produced by me.
That's cool. So let's go back to your childhood, man. Only sibling, or you got other sisters? I know you I think you got three sisters. Four sisters, five. Yo, I told you, I do the research, man. So that TV don't play, man. When you get on this seat, I'm going to find out things about you. But start off with your bio, man. Because yo, I'm going to tell you back your words and everything. I read it and I do my research. Yo, but how they doing? All y'all went together?
I don't have no sisters, though.
No, you got sisters. Oh, God. I'm sorry.
Little brother.
Little brother? That's
it?
Yeah. I saw a lot of sisters. But I ain't going to, you know.
I can't.
Y'all just doing my research, man. I'm bringing it to the TV. But
I got a lot of cousins.
Cousins, yeah.
I just got the one little.
How mom and pops, man?
They all right.
They still together, or you know? Not the last one. I mean, if you want to talk about it,
they working.
I asked you
out.
before. Yeah?
They working things out. I don't put too much out.
That's the best thing you can do, but, man. You know, it's the best thing you can do.
Yeah, because you know, at the end of the day. Like, I know it's life and you go through stuff.
Hell yeah.
Anyway, but at the end of the day, you need that person that loves you and that you love too.
And you know, yo, so, my thing is, you never get old with the person that you were young with.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? Facts. I got poetry, man. I got poetry, man.
Nah, but they good. My mother, like, she was
who was the disciplining? Let's hit it down from the bottom. Who sat down to discipline in the house, man?
Nah. I can say it had to come from both, but it was just different perspectives. But it came from both sides, but different perspectives.
Yeah. And your brother's younger or older? You say
my younger. Brother younger. He just turned 21 this year.
Mm. Yeah. That's true. Which one is that? I don't know. I did my research on Facebook, Twitter, and all that shit.
My brother, what do you mean, his name?
Yeah, his name.
It's Latrell.
Latrell, shout out Latrell, man. Yo, your brother's got a good brother here, man. Older brother, man. Keep him in. I know he loves you. He gotta love you.
I don't know.
He gotta look.
You know how sibling rivalry is.
So who you follow behind? What's your DNA strand pushing for? Mommy or daddy, man? Did you find yourself
closer to my mother?
So then you act like your dad.
Nah. I actually is more like her too.
What was the music in the house? Your dad? Anybody in the house?
That's the thing. Not really. I got family that do sing and everything, and I got family that do all work and everything.
Yeah.
But actually, my cousin is Ella Fitzgerald.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Yo, can he do the S.O.T.A.tv series, man? Word up, man. You know, word up, man. Start from the bottom, man. Right.
My mother sings.
But she other sings. Than that, man, I'm happy to hear that, man.
She was on the choir, so I used to be on the choir when I was younger too, but that's why we used to, like, when I grew up off of music, it was never actually all rap and everything. I didn't come straight from rap. I used to listen
to
R&B and all that because my parents didn't want me, you know, hearing all of that going on in the rap music.
That was a rock and roll, right?
Like, that was a crazy time. So, yeah, I grew up off of stuff like Earth, Wind & Fire, Temptations, Jodeci.
Nothing wrong with that, man. Yeah. Nothing wrong with that at all, man. Nah. At all, man. So, but other than that, damn, you threw me off when you said Gerald LaVert, man. You know what I'm saying? So, what are you doing right now lately and doing the things, man? Because I know you went to high school, college for engineering. I did the same thing, man. Alfred Smith High School, man. Vocational High School, man. I did the thing.
For college, yeah. I went to, it was for more architecture.
Yeah.
So,
that's good, man. You know about the pencils and all that other good stuff.
All of that.
Right? You know what I'm saying?
It's a little bit too much.
I almost went to Brooklyn Tech for it, man, to go finish up. But
I think I know somebody that's going in there to finish.
Did you like it? Did you you was doing since high school? What was you doing?
No, I was doing that after.
How was
after
you in high school?
High school. I actually started with drawing, but it was more fine art.
Right.
It wasn't anything architectural, but that's what I did mostly. I had the chance at the last minute to, you know, be with the music group, but
What's the name of that music group?
Nah, I mean for like for the school for and school. Everything, but it was like too late to get the extra credit
right.
put up. But I came out of there and then I went to DMCC for a little bit for the film work and everything.
That's good.
But then switched over to architecture, and it was dope. It was dope for what it was.
Like,
but it was
just
a lot of stuff. It was a lot to process. And at that time in my life, that was when I had like really took serious everything I was doing with my
music.
We
get back to more of that, man. We're going into break right now. It's a mission. This is S.O.T.A. TV series up at Ornament Studios. I got AE right here, right there from the Ninja Nation Coalition, man. We check it out. Welcome back to the S.O.T.A. TV series. I'm DirtyPromesa, and to the left of me, man, is AE, man. He just got finished touching down the booth with his two tracks from his EP, The Broken Artist, but this one is Flow, The Flow.
No way can stop the flow, no way can stop the flow. Everything I do, no way can stop the flow, no way can stop the flow. Do what I do, cause I got something to prove. No way can stop the flow, no way can stop the flow. Put me on the stage, I put on the show. No way can stop the flow, no way can stop the flow. Life is one on end, and everybody knows.
Yeah, we back from intermission. It's S.O.T.A. TV series. I'm sitting down with the talented artist, man, the feature of this show today, A.E., about to put out, talking about his EP, The Broken Artist. He ripped it today, man. You're going to see some of the work he did in the booth, kicking the joint, the flow, and also ups and downs, man. So you're going to check it out. I'm Dirty Promesa. We're filming right now, Ottoman Studios in the South Bronx, 381 Canal Place. So if you ever want to step to the show or come to the show, we introduce some promos, interviews, you can also send an email to takeoverpromotions4@gmail.com. You can also send your bio and also title it interested in the show and stuff like that, man. There you go. Thank you. But, so we was talking a little bit about his schooling. He went to architect before we went into break, intermission. Excuse my throat. So we have something in common. We both studied architecture in school, which is, I find, really cool because, you know, unique minds. You don't see too many people you run into and be like, yo, you did architecture, unless those people already moved on and surpassed, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, so, but he's here to represent his EP, The Broken Artist. That's what we're here to talk about. But like the S.O.T.A. TV series like to give out, man, it's more about more than music. And we like to know who A.E. is, man, because he's striving and grinding for his dream, man. And, you know, he has very talented. I met him 3 or 4 years ago, just to give you a little back if you missed the first part of it. So how did you meet Sets, man? Because I know how I met Sets. I met Sets at a venue. This is how I met Sets at a venue.
Yeah.
I had Smash Mouth. I did Up In Here. Oh, man, I swear to God, I killed that shit. Everybody was up. And that was it. He came in the hallway, introduced me. And I always said, I'm going to keep it real with everybody, man. He asked me if I'd like to join the thing, the coalition. I was like, yo, I'm really doing my own thing. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is where, now you see where it led. You know, I'm hoping bigger and better. But it starts with you, and once again, thank you, man, for coming out and supporting the S.O.T.A. TV series, man. Take over promotion, production. You know, I hope to work with you anyway. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I put that on camera. Let everybody know I like to network. But once again, you're my feature talent. It's all about you. I don't want to make it sound like about me. But you're here, A.E. You teared it up in the booth. When did you start writing for that EP, man?
About last year. Like right after the last stop on the tour, which was ATL, we had stopped in North Carolina.
Okay.
And we actually met up with a producer out there.
Yo, how is it out there? Because I'm trying to get
nice.
Out there. I got a sister
nice.
To live out
pretty
there.
Nice. Shout out Bushead. What's his name? He sent out some beats to us too that we did. It was pretty dope. And at that point, I was actually doing a whole nother project. And
which one was that? Just give it his name. You had a name for it already or no?
Yeah, I'm still dropping it. I'm gonna drop it. There's another
two
point.
Projects, you know what I'm saying? Whatever's old to you is new to anybody else. So we're gonna try to talk about that.
It was called Memoirs of a Piehead, and it was supposed to be my reflections on the things that I go through, you know, as a
Nigga
or whatever.
Through that whole year,
but that switched up from when I got back. Because after I got back, I'm thinking more about every single thing I went through. And this is when I started making the beats and everything.
Okay.
So after I started, like, you know, messing with the beats, it took a couple minutes to get the right tracks to what I wanted to do. And then I started writing. And it just came to me, you know. I was just reflecting on everything that I went through like they go here in ups and downs, basically reflection of the ups and downs, everything that I go through, because my music is different from majority of the people that's working with Ninja Nation and everything.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because they have more of a, you know, hype kind of, you know, music and everything with the turn up and everything. Shout out to YD.
Wait.
Most of the venues that we did were like clubs, maybe a strip club, stuff like that. And I had like one track maybe off of my last project, which was Broken Artistry. That's up on natpiff.com.
Okay.
Go check that out.
Check it out.
This is the song I had mindset. That's the song. Yeah, I got the shirt done because he was performing that. But that was like the one track I had. Everybody else was like really
good. What was your dopest one out there that y'all did, man?
Like the shows?
Yeah, the shows we did.
The last thing that we did at Black Thorn, which was the release for the Ninja Nation, the Ninja Nation Coalition mixtape, which is also on that bit.
Yo, and I gotta thank Sets and all of y'all too, man, you know what I'm saying? Because y'all support them, to do that thing. That was my first time that I had my first venue, man. And you know what I'm saying? I had the equipment. I felt like I was prepared for it. And I definitely hope that y'all enjoyed the photos that I took from there. You know? Because I was up and down. Like, I took it business. You know what I'm saying? I really took it business. Yeah. And I was up and down doing it. That was dope, man. That was totally dope. You know, and all of y'all ripped your set, man. And I like that, man. So how did you feel when you did that? Like, that was good, man.
Yeah, it was different. That was different. Like, it was the first event that we did that... It's just about us. You know, it wasn't nothing random.
Big shout out to the DJ. What's the DJ name again, man? I know.
Dang, so got me at a blink right now.
Yo, big shout out to the DJ. I edited that
away.
But how was it working with them, man? Like, I'm sure, man, like you working with YD and your boy. What's his name again, man?
Easy does it.
Oh, he's wild. I like his energy. I ain't gonna lie, I like his energy. I like the white boys. How's he working with white boys, man? The collar boys.
It's like they cool. Everything is not. I'm not even gonna lie. We had some good times, and it was still at the same time we had our ups and downs.
Yeah.
But it was cool. This is the first time I did something with somebody, and then it was a bonding experience.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and they my peoples for life. That's just a general.
Look, I forgot. I did think I cut you off, man. I apologize. You didn't tell me how you met Sets, man.
Yeah, Sets. That was at Brooklyn Nights. I did. That was one of my first couple of shows.
Where's that at? Where's Brooklyn Nights at?
It's on DeKalb. I don't even remember the cross streets right now.
Wow.
But it's right where that Biggie Memorial is.
Oh, okay. How was it? That was there.
It was dope. That was one of my first like second or third shows that I did, and Seth was just there, and I met him. I got his contact, but I didn't really converse with him from there. We had met up maybe a year later. And I had saw him at one of these series that we did, one of Kings of Sun series. And he was there, and I was like, yo, I remember him. He dope. He got the chain on.
Yeah, he got the chain, but he got the motherfucking
chain. He saw me perform. I got off the stage, and he gave me his cardigan. And it's crazy because, I had hit him maybe once. But it was like 99. So then the third time when we met up was with this coalition thing, and that was random as hell because I come up in there, he there, and I'm like, what? I guess I'm supposed to know this nigga. I guess I'm supposed to be cool with him. All right, let's see what happens. And then from there, everything just been copacetic.
Just copacetic, right?
Everything been cool.
That motherfucker smoke a lot of weed and shit, yo.
Yeah, he do.
He a cool motherfucker. I big him up as much as I can, man.
Crazy.
Worried up, man. So then he helped you out with a lot of your promotions or stuff like that. All part of your EP. Is anybody on your EPs? Put the word out. We got 48 seconds. We don't got to rush it. We can push you into the next segment.
I'm more happy with this too, because this is my solo thing.
I know.
I did everything, myself with. Help her, supporters, help my girl.
Yeah,
help with a couple of my family members too, but
like, who's that with you? You gave him a shout out? I know we said you want to give him a shout out or anonymous back there? Because I appreciate y'all sitting down, y'all seeing what I'm doing, you know what I'm saying? And I'm gonna make sure this is gonna work right, but
it's just right now.
Another thing, since we got you mic'd up, yeah, you can't muffle your face or hit your collar because it's gonna get muffled up. The way I edit that out. But anyway, let's break to this intermission. We think of our thoughts and get everything together. S.O.T.A. TV Series AE. Oh man, we here, man.
If any singers, rappers, poets, dancers, painters, or anyone who would like to be interviewed by TakeOver Promotion and we find it interesting, please submit your bio into one of these emails or social networks. Thank you very much. TakeOver Promotions.
Welcome back to S.O.T.A. TV Series. Talented AE straight from Marcy Projects from Brooklyn. He's about to show us his new song straight out of his EP, The Broken Artist. This one is featured Ups and Downs. Check it out again, man.
Don't take a genius to know, I've been in pain. Lost people in my life, the needle been in vain. Every thought off track, I can't catch the train. Watching everybody act as if it's all the same. The change they frame just to fit the game. Nah, man, I really can't do it. Keep my mind confined, I really can't lose it. Feel like I'm living life wrong, but I can't prove it. Got a mountain in my way and I can't move it. Take a lot to live this life, but I gotta do it. Where you? I'm not really feeling this change. Where you? Different picture, but the frame is the same. Man, it's always the same. Up and down, up and down I go. Up and down, up and down I go. Up and down, up and down I go.
Up and down, up and down I go.
Up and down, up and down, up and down I go.
Up and down,
up and down, up and down I go.
Up and down,
up and down, up and down I go.
Up and down, up and down I go.
I go. Searching for a better way, knowing I have better days. On my way to the top, it's a flight that can't be delayed. Putting together mixtapes and EPKs. Put myself out there to see what the streets will say. In the back of my mind, I'm hoping I'm not wasting my time. Deep in my heart, I feel like this is where I was meant to be from the start. That's why the same people aren't here from the start. I'm a ninja from a new nation, taking the same shots, but you can get it in a new casing. No debating, I'm penetrating the game full force. No more back and forth like an old wooden horse. Kill me beat, of course, I can knock anybody off course. I live for the applause. Leaving crowds in an uproar. I'm a lion facing the top, that's an uproar. The way they hating got me calling up to plug more. This is my outlet on life, man. To give it up, what for? Up and down, up and down I go. Up and down, up and down I go.
Up and down,
up and down I go.
Up and down, up and down I go.
Up and down, up and down I go.
Up and down,
up and down, up and down I go. Up and down, up and down I go.
Up and down, up and down I go.
Chilling out in Ottoman Studios with Dirty Promesa and S.O.T.A. TV. Take over promotions.
Welcome back to the S.O.T.A. TV Series, man. This is the third season. Right now, he's sitting the feature artist, the talented artist. Today, we have his right here, AE, man, coming to promote his EP, The Broken Artist. He killed it in the booth once again, man. Like, I always have to stress, man. He just ripped it with the flow. And he also did another joint off of that EP called The Broken Artist, Ups and Downs, man. And we talked about his ups and downs, his strive, his grind for the dream, those he worked with, those he's passionate, what his passion is, man, his family, his life. Because I tell you, on S.O.T.A. TV Series, it's more than just music, man. I want to let everybody know who I bring to this seat so that you can be a real admirer of your work. Because I put the work in on the show, man, and I make sure that the artist is all about the feature artist for it. Yeah, Kashan right here. But before we get it back into you, man, who's that dude that just walked in here, man? You know what I'm saying? Crazy That's dude, right man.
Over there.
Yeah, man.
Mr. Mask, man. Yeah, shout out Trey and entertainment, yo. Yeah, if it wasn't for him, son, I wouldn't have been performing, you know. It was before I was performing. I was just making music at that point, and I ran into him, and he got me into all these events and everything. So
that's good, man. That's good, yo. That's great, man. So big shout out to him, man. And so he helped you with the EP, or that was where, you know what I'm saying, y'all just doing things. Y'all work, y'all got anything together that people could see on
We still got that video up, right? I feel it too. You go on my YouTube. That was a song we did like a couple years back.
Come around here. Bring me AE's EP, man. You know what I'm saying? It's over here. How many tracks is on this joint right here, man?
Five tracks
right here on this joint right here. This is the EP. Don't worry, we'll shine it. We'll make sure. It's five tracks, man. Is the names on the tracks right here in the front, or you know what I'm saying? So tell us the names of the tracks. You remember all the names and break them down, like what made you create it and write it.
The first track is No Answer, which is me basically stating I'm putting my foot in the door and I'm knocking to be a part of this industry, but nobody's really hearing me. And then it goes into the flow, which is like basically, all right, that's cool, but I'm still doing what I gotta do, okay. You know? And then the next track after that is Shade, which is basically touching base on, you know, all of the
shadiness that goes on.
Yeah.
How hard do you think it is to really break in, man? Do you know, I'm sure with the grind you put in, you know what it takes to get in the game, or, you know what I'm saying, and Rich Entertainment help you with that?
Well, if you just trying to be a part of this industry the way it is right now, my music ain't the type of music they looking for. So it's a little bit harder.
So you're pushing as independent, right?
It's a little bit harder, yeah. Trying to stay independent like Chance.
Because
he doing good. So I'm just doing my own thing, you know?
And what's the third track? Give me the name of the third track.
The third track is Shade. The fourth track is Ups and Downs. And the last track is Keep Moving.
Okay.
It's basically, you know, I've been doing all this stuff. And at the end of the day, it was motivation for me to keep doing what I'm doing because I feel like I'm really in the right place and what I'm supposed to be doing in life.
So have you done what is that thing with Trey that we met up again in Brooklyn? The 105?
Oh, yeah.
The 105, have you done that? What is that? It's big. He works, because I met him through Brooklyn at that, you know what I'm saying, another schooling that I went to. Stuff like that.
I
sure
did that one.
The Bar 105. Bar 105, man. You know what I'm saying? Okay. I went out there, did my thing and shit. Trey was loud as fucking hell.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? 458,
I did one of those tracks. I actually recently did one of them with him.
Yeah. Yo, I uploaded my joint to the DJ thing and she took my song, man. I had to go back to my studio and redo that and like not redo it, but just get the upload again, man. Mm. When I upload it. But we're here for you, man, the EP, the Broken Artist, man, right here, you know what I'm saying? So some of the past venues you did was Black Dawn. What's the number one you done? That I know you said Black Dawn 51 was the biggest one you ever done, but what's some of the spots you done hit up at?
Black Dawn.
Do you stay local in Brooklyn only? Because I know y'all be putting out a lot of venues, man. Compare to what y'all do.
Recently, I've been doing just shows within New York. But like I said, last year, we was going out of state.
What's your last Coalition show, man?
That was the
last one?
Black Thorn.
Well, I'm happy that one was there.
Everybody,
explode, like.
Everybody since then been working on their solo thing.
I think it was Eagles, but... It's all right. Yo, I think now because all of y'all had your own entity, and y'all did each one of y'all blew.
Well,
man,
I mean,
you know
it's
what I'm
like
saying?
Because before that whole thing, before we even got together and everything, everybody was doing stuff, but they wasn't like this. Took it to a whole other level and opened up our eyes to a whole.
I know the
mixtape
doing great, man. I think over 2,000, 3,000. Views, I mean,
it was way up,
right?
It was like beyond that.
Well, I know
it was
one
a glitch,
of them,
they took it down,
yeah.
And then we put it back up, and the numbers came back. Not as much, but it still came back.
Yeah.
That was pretty dope. But everybody, like, you know, when we got back, it was like more of a we learned a lot going through everything we went through, so we had to put it back into our own self. So that's why everybody separate to do their own separate projects, but. Pretty sure as soon as everything is all settled up with ourselves, we're going to come together and do something
else. That's good. I mean, y'all together enough times in that I don't call it a basement because the house is a house. It's just a room.
The Genation base.
Yeah, right? The base and everything down there, man. I like the whole setup over there. So how was it in Marcy? You still in Marcy right now? Or?
Yeah, for right now. I'm actually trying to save up to move. I don't know where exactly yet, but
it's getting expensive over there, I heard, man. It's starting to get expensive. They're turning those warehouses into condominiums.
Well, my grandmother been there for a whole, all my life, or a couple other siblings in them life, so she good with the rent. They can keep it controlled, but
the thing is, they trying to build on the Indian shit. They could damn well take our shit over. You into politics and stuff like that?
I try not to. I try not to get into it. But
I know you're a Democrat. I can't assume you're Republican. I can't assume you're a Democrat. So I actually.
Listen, at this point in time, I feel like
I'm trying to get ass out of you, man.
Yeah, but I feel like at this point in time, honestly, you feel
it's
like
real right now.
And I don't know. I really don't think it really freaking matters at the end of the day because at the end of the day, Democrat, Republican, nothing. Nobody changing our lives. Yeah. Ain't nobody fixing nothing. You got a lot of black people dying right now.
You think what's going on with the Black Lives Matter and our people's, it's just a push for, like a higher push for martial law? Just to get the people.
That's why they want us to get. They want us to get crazy and start rioting and everything, just so they can do that.
Right?
Just so they can put us back.
Put it back under
their control.
Build the wall, do everything they want to do. Right.
But at the same time,
I'm into all that.
It's crazy.
This is my first time I've ever asked somebody this, man.
You're
a very educated man. You got college in your belt.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Engineer technician. So we good with that. You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't just take that class and shit. So I know I'm talking to somebody with a brain on the show.
I know a lot of people saying voting matters and all that and this, that, and the fourth, and we fought for this and doing that. There's a lot of stuff we fought for we still don't have. And I feel like there's a lot of stuff that they say we have that we don't have. Yeah. It's like no such thing as freedom. Everybody is still a slave to something.
Something, right?
Like, so I'm not even sure if our votes count because I'm pretty sure a lot of people in Brooklyn voted for Bernie. How the hell?
That's some other shit between politicians and politicians. That was another hand filling another hand. You know what I'm saying? You know how that goes.
This is just,
I ain't trying to take you off the EP right here, the broken artist. You know what I'm saying? Just like I tell, I like to let my fans know who you are, man.
Yeah.
I want them to follow you. I hope by being on this show right now that your views and your shares go up. You understand? Because I followed you. I've known you for like 2-3 years. And I know you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, if we can network again, like our son said, man, we can network with the cameras and we can bring out more cameras. You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
Maybe from this start on, maybe we could build a business together. I'm all about networking, bro.
Yeah, making
that's
that next
my
move.
Thing. I ain't not about bullshitting the next artist. I keep it 100, man.
Yeah.
That's all you can do. Just make sure we have an understanding between each other and stuff like that. You know, so I'm gonna get into this. This is called Dirty Questions, man. Some of them are raunchy, some of them might be soft, some of them might be left, some of them might be right. But this is the part of the section where I try to get my fan base to smile a little bit, make the artist feel a little nervous and easy. It's nothing hard. It's just ask a question, yes, no, one question if that's all you want to give. All right, man. All
right.
So this is where we'll go. You know, would we like to go to the fan? The fan got a question. We have a fan in here that like to ask you a question. Go ahead, guys. What's that?
My question is...
Come on. Wait, go right here. Come on.
Yeah.
All right, so bet. So this is right?
Come on.
So my question is about the politics, right? I got to ask you about it. But who you really think going to win? Hillary or Bernie? I mean, not Bernie. Trump. See? Can't even think straight. Hillary or Trump.
Dang, I really can't even say right now.
Yeah,
I have no idea, but I feel like either way, it ain't good, in all honesty.
It ain't working. Like, one's a compulsive liar, right?
It's like, well, if Trump get it, then things might just go to hell hella fast. And then if Hillary get it, things going to go to hell hella slow. But at the same time, it's going to hell.
It
ain't for us. But I feel like even when they put Obama in office, that was still a trick to get people's hopes up and everything. Like, no, I am nothing towards him. And I know a lot of people say, oh, he didn't do nothing. You got to understand all of the stuff that was built up before he even got into office that was already fucked up, that they pushed on him.
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
Yo, thank you for sharing
your
views.
I'm trying to
maybe I might go into politics now with the show, man. Get some. I'm trying to get everybody, really. It ain't just about music and stuff like that. Nizzy, that's my boy Nizzy coming in, making a noise and everything. Just put it up with that. We still recording. All right, brother. We'll edit that. Nah, he ain't here yet. We got a question again?
I got one more question.
All right, one more question. Make it fast, man. We pushing time.
All right, so you think about put a freestyle beat right now, right? You make a freestyle by Butter Rose?
That's a good one.
Probably. That's really what you want to
do. You want to do it? Yeah. You want to do it for the fans? That's be your next fan right there. She'll follow.
All
right,
would it be that?
These kids are ingenious with the gadgets nowadays. Well, I don't know. You got a beat? You got more. 5 seconds. Four, three. Next time, man. Next time. But you're a fan. That's AE, man. Let's go. So what's your son?
Leo.
Do you vote? Once again, I asked him.
Hey.
All right. Lover or fighter?
Lover.
Lover. Do you believe college is needed for the entertainment businesses so you can shine?
That's not a straight off yes or no thing. It's like yes.
Entertainment field, yes.
Like when it comes to the business, there's a certain a lot of things that you can do. But at the same time, there's also a lot of books you could just read.
Okay. Is spoken word still one of your loves?
Yeah, I tell them from time to time I do, but it's more into the music.
You know, I gotta put you in the hot seat now. Here we go. Do you sing to your lady?
Oh, I got a couple songs about her.
You got a couple songs?
Yeah.
Give me two. Crying songs? You my lady.
Nah, I got a song. It's a song on another mix that I did behind I. It, it's basically about from the start I saw her and then how it went.
How long have you got her?
4 years.
That's great, man. You ain't got the 5 years yet. God bless you and I hope your work, man. So that leads on to the next question. Do you believe in marriage?
Yes. But it's just a lot.
Ain't no buts. You want to get you ready?
I really do. That's not what I don't mean from that. I mean, in general, of how the world is now. Yeah. You know? But yes, I do specifically.
It's crazy when I hear females say, oh, it's only just a piece of paper. Now, I always still gonna stoop me to this day, when they say it. Yeah. We can say it, but it's only a piece of paper.
Yeah, when they say it. But in the day, when it comes to, especially if you're living your life with that person, and then when it comes to children, there's a lot of things that you need that piece of paper for.
So you think marriage needs to change because of, just like the Bible?
Needed
to change because that was their time. The Bible should be written for this time to be understood. But what stayed basic is just a revolution. How you say it? A revolving door of just basic life, man. Think it need to be changed? There's only one word question. I was just trying to fuck with you. Best sport you like, man?
Sport? Football. Yeah.
Football? What's your favorite team?
Giants.
They lost this week.
Yeah.
Yo, one of your favorite artists growing up, besides Jay-Z, man. You guys in the old school joints?
Yeah.
All right, so give me one of your best artists of your old school, man, because that was hip-hop.
I have to say Michael.
Michael what?
Jackson.
I said hip-hop.
You said hip-hop artist?
Yeah. Oh, no, because you hip-hop wasn't your thing, right?
Yeah, I was more into the R&B and everything.
Oh, hell.
But
really, you think Michael or Prince?
Michael.
Nah, you get it wrong. It's James Brown, brother. That brother taught all of them how to do this motherfucking wiggly shake, man. But anyway, man, I'm a history buff. Man. Yeah. I love history, whether it's everything. You know what I'm saying? So this is the last question. Please get it right. What show are you on right now?
We have a S.O.T.A.tv show.
Produced by TakeOver Promotions. I'm DirtyPromesa. We are Ultimate Studios. We're going to break it out right now. This is A.E., you know what I'm saying, out here to promote his EP, The Broken Artist. And he just killed it once again. He did two of his joints called The Flow and Ups and Downs, man. I thank you very again. I'm going to switch hands and bless you. And I wish you much success. I'll still be following you, man. I hope that we can make work together. You shoot my video, I shoot your video. You know, the barter system.
That's what it is.
Yo. Last thing I want to ask you. You do your editing?
Yes.
What'd you use, Final Cut or
Final Cut?
Final Cut, right?
Yeah, Final Cut.
Damn. I was hoping you said Adobe. But anyway, yo, check it out. That's it for us, man. One of the studios, AE, man. Preaching this EP right now. About to drop soon. The Broken Artist, man. I wish him much success. I'm Dirty Promesa, S.O.T.A.tvseries, the acronym for supporting other talented artists. And I got my one thing I got to do. Pinkies up. That means loyalty, royalty, and respect. And I don't change that shit for nobody. Word up. So here we go. Break it out. And...
She's top gonna take it, whether you applaud it or hate it. I give us more motivation, we gonna make it. The seed top gonna take it, whether you applaud it or hate it. I give us more motivation, we gonna make it. The seed top gonna take it, whether you